Hello, YouTubers, shooters, reloaders, Flyer556 coming to you today. Coming to you from the bedroom today because it's a freezing cold January day in 2017 here in central New Jersey. Good day to make a new video. And it's been a while since I put anything new on your computer or your TV screen, so I'm going to put something new out there today. Over the last, approximately the last year, I bought several new guns, and I'm going to start with the first one I bought a year ago, if that makes sense. It's an AK. This is it here. It's made by Arsenal. And the main purpose of this video is, one, going to be to show you guys my new AK. Well, it's a year old now, but it's still pretty new. Okay? It's made by Arsenal. And the main purpose of this video is also to show not only the Arsenal and my new AK, but an AK that's New Jersey compliant. It's not exactly easy to find. I kind of found that out the hard way. I never showed too much interest in AKs. I mainly was into ARs. I'm not even too into rifles, actually. You guys all know I'm big on handguns and competition shooting with the Glocks and the 1911s and all that stuff. But I am a little into rifles, and you know I got my fair share of them, and I'm into the ARs, but I started thinking about considering getting into an AK just to have one. And I started looking at the Century C39. I liked what I saw, and then they came out with the C39 V2, the version 2, and it had outstanding reviews. It's a very fair price. It's a milled receiver. Not to get off the subject of this, I'm just trying to explain and elaborate a little bit on what's up with the whole New Jersey thing, because that's an important part of this video that I'm trying to demonstrate and stress here. Anybody that's interested in owning one of these weapons that lives in New Jersey, it's not exactly easy to find one. So anyhow, the place I shoot in Easton, there's two gun shops there. I go to almost every week, Sarco and Heritage. And they both have a lot of AKs, Sarco especially. So I went to them first. I went in and I asked to see the C39 V2. And the guy knew right away. He knew where I'm from because I purchased several rifles there. And he was like, "You're from Jersey, aren't you?" And I was like, "Yeah." He was like, I'm not even going to show you the gun because I can't sell it to you. It's store policy." And I asked him why, and he explained that it's just store policy. They just won't do it. So, with that said, I walked out, I went next door to Heritage, I went in there, they all know me, I'm there every week, and I asked them, I said, "What's the deal with the AKs?" I said, "You guys got any C39 V2s by Century?" He's like, "Absolutely," he said, "but I can't sell you one, sir." I said, "What's the problem, New Jersey?" He's like, "Yeah, it's store policy." He said, "Anywhere you go in PA is going to tell you the same thing. They're not going to sell you the gun. Even if it is compliant, they're not going to take the risk of jeopardizing their FFL in case for some reason it's found out that it isn't compliant. It could jeopardize their FFL, and they're not going to risk that over a simple sale of one firearm. It's not worth it to them." They told me, if you're really interested in buying one of these, you're going to have to go to New Jersey, and you're going to have to find somebody that's got a New Jersey compliant one. And that's the route you're going to have to go. So it was a Saturday. I went on a Saturday because I wanted to go when Sarco was open. And it was, and they were. And I walked out of there kind of disgusted. And by the way, the Century was $800, which I thought was a very fair price. It's a good gun. It's a milled receiver. It's not stamped. Again, not trying to get off the subject, but trying to explain a little bit about the whole New Jersey thing. I was ready to spend the $800. More than willing, happy with the $800 for the Century. So anyway, I left. I drove back to Jersey. Heritage in New Jersey was still open. I went to them. I know they had a couple AKs in there at the time I was there prior to it, before I was interested in getting into an AK. So I went in, saw a guy that I was familiar with. He knows me. I know him. His name is Jim. I said, "Jim, you got any AKs?" He's like, "Let me look." He looked. He said, "Yeah, we got one. It's an Arsenal. It's kind of pricey." I said, "Let me see it." So he handed me the gun. This is the gun. And I looked at it, I looked at the price, it was $15.89, I think was the price before Nixon tax. It was $15.89, and I said, wow, that's twice what I was looking at. And he started to go into explaining why it's so much money, and I'll explain that in a moment when I get through what I'm explaining now about why it's so much money. But he also explained that it's New Jersey compliant, and it's one of the few, only ones that are New Jersey compliant, and that's another reason that it's expensive, because it's a process they got to go through to make them compliant. So after being told basically that I can't have one unless I can find one that is compliant in Jersey, without hesitation I was like, well, let's get on with the paperwork, Jim. I want to take this home today. Okay, so that's how that went. That's how I ended up with my AK, my arsenal, which is like top shelf far as AK goes, from what I know. I'm not no AK know-it-all, far from it. I actually got a little piece of information printed out here that I'm going to read you guys about this specific gun, because I don't know everything about it, and I figured I'm better off reading it right off their website in case you guys are interested about it. I don't want to give you bad information. I'm just going to give you a little bit that is fact, that is from Arsenal about the gun, so I get it right. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the gun down on the floor so you guys can get a better look at it, zoom in on it, and I'm going to read you this little piece of information I have. Okay, the gun has been safety checked, by the way. It is clear. Okay, so here we go. Let me zoom in a little bit on the weapon that we're looking at here. Okay. And that's my new arsenal. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, I'm just going to read a little bit of information about the gun. Arsenal, this is the model is the SAM Sam Apple Mary 7R Ralph. SAM 7R, that's the model number, the New Jersey compliant model number. Okay, this is what the little piece of information says. Arsenal Incorporated, the premier American importer and manufacturer of semi-auto rifles, is proud to offer to American shooters the Bulgarian-made SAM-7R. This 7.62x39 caliber rifle combines authentic high-quality features rarely seen in the American market. From its intermediate length trapdoor buttstock to its removable four-port muzzle brake, every component of the SAM-7R is engineered to provide decades of dependable and accurate service. The SAM-7R rifle is bound to become a sought-after shooter and collectible firearm. Now, I just want to say one thing about what I just read. My muzzle brake in particular is not removable. It's pinned and welded to make it New Jersey compliant, but the non-New Jersey compliant models would be removable. Okay, with that said, I'm going to go on and read here. Arsenal's exclusive milled and forged receiver. Each 7AM7R receiver is milled from a hot die hammer forged receiver blank by Arsenal Company of Bulgaria. Other milled receiver AKs are machined from bar stock, but Arsenal's hot die hammer forging produces strong and finer grained steel. Internal voids and cooling deformations are eliminated by the 5-ton hammer forging process. Each forged receiver blank requires over 5.5 hours of milling before assembly. This forging and milling process is complex and time intensive, but Arsenal's meticulous attention to detail delivers a receiver of unequaled strength, precision, and durability. Now, with that said, I'm just going to say a couple things about that. Arsenal in Bulgaria is a company. There's also an arsenal that I'm going to read about in the next part, in Las Vegas, Nevada. They're two completely separate companies. Arsenal in Bulgaria makes the receiver of this gun. Arsenal in Las Vegas, Nevada, which is a completely separate company, they're the ones that take the gun and make it New Jersey compliant. Okay, with that said, I'm going to continue reading now. Summary. 7AM 7AM7R-61 762x39 caliber rifle, milled and forged receiver, chrome lined hammer forged barrel, 14mm muzzle threads, muzzle brake, cleaning rod, bayonet lug, black polymer furniture, intermediate length buttstock, scope rail, and one 10-round magazine, sling, oil bottle, and cleaning kit. Features 100% production parts and components, Bulgarian hot die hammer forged receiver, bolt carrier, and double hook trigger, cold hammer forged 16.3-inch barrel from Arsenal's Bulgarian factory, built on a Steyr manufacturing technology, hard chrome plated bore and chamber, removable 4-port muzzle brake with 14mm by 1mm left-hand threads, intermediate length US-made 10-inch trapdoor buttstock, total length of pull is 13.4 inches, subsequently extended service life over other types of assemblies, 922R compliant with US or imported magazines, and an AK scope rail, which is, as you can see, is riveted on this side of the receiver. Also, briefly, I'm going to show you this little tag. This came right off the box of the gun. This will show you the serial number, the part number, SAM7R, and it says right there, New Jersey and New York state compliant. Okay, this is for this gun. Okay, so with all that said, pretty much all I wanted to do was show you guys the gun, talk about it a little bit. I'm going to zoom in, try and show you a little better picture of it, a little bit closer up. Let's see. I don't know, we'll see what we can get out of this. As you can see here, made in Bulgaria, see there? That's where the receiver is made and milled out and hammer forged and all that good stuff. And then over here, if you can read that, it says Arsenal, Las Vegas, Nevada. That's the other company. That's the company that makes the gun New Jersey compliant. And yes, that is a PMAG, a 10-round PMAG in there. It accepts them with no problem. There's the fore end where the piston is. It's a 90-degree gas block. They say it's better than a 45. I think the 45 looks cooler, but the gun comes with a 90, and they say that that's better. Don't know. Going with what I read and researched. Okay, that's the muzzle brake. Standard AK front sight. Okay. I'm going to zoom back out now. I'm going to flip the gun over so you guys can see the other side of it. Okay. Zoom in a little bit here. There's the other side of the receiver. Okay. Basically, that's about it, guys. That's my Arsenal. It's New Jersey compliant. Pretty cool gun. I shot it a couple times, about 150 times, each time with various types of ammo. I sighted it in at 50 yards, and I was shooting clay birds with it, holding it about 6 o'clock with the open sights to come with the gun. Hitting 2 out of 3 every time at 100 yards. I'm told for an AK that's pretty good accuracy, because they're not exactly the most accurate weapons, but the Arsenals with that cold hammer forged chrome lined barrel and chamber are just... they're second to none. It's a really, really well-made weapon. From what I'm told, there is no better. Not really what I was looking for. Like I said, I wanted the $800 Century, but I ended up with this little over $1,600 out the door Arsenal. And I still got my eyes open. I'd still like to find a compliant, less expensive AK that I could just take to the range and shoot the hell out of. But right now, that's not exactly in my reach. I'm having trouble finding it, so I'm just happy and thankful that I got what I got. And I know I got a good one, because even Hickok 45 says the same thing, that he didn't know too much about them, and he just went for top shelf, and he bought himself two Arsenals, and he just went that route, knowing that they were the best, and that's why he bought what he bought. And going with that also, that's another reason I bought it. One, because it was the only one I could find, and two, knowing that he said they're good, that's enough insurance for me. So anyway, thanks for watching the video, guys. If you liked it, please hit the like button. Hopefully you subscribed. If not, please subscribe if you don't mind, and don't hesitate to share this. And thanks again, everybody, for watching my video on my AK. I'll talk to you soon. Flyer 556, I'm out.